What's good, everyone? OJ here. Welcome back to another video. Today, we've got a pretty big one here because we're going to be talking about the Nintendo Switch and if it has a legitimate shot at becoming the best-selling dedicated gaming device of all time. Not just the best-selling Nintendo device of all time, but the actual best-selling dedicated gaming console or device of all time. So this includes systems from Microsoft, Sony, of course Nintendo, you had Atari back in the day, all of that. There is a big list of consoles, and the Switch is impressively fastly shooting up the list here, and it's not too far behind. It's already within striking distance of the Game Boy Advance, which sold over 81 million systems worldwide. The Nintendo Switch is right about at 80 million at this point. So now many people are starting to wonder if this system could become the best-selling one of all time. And we're gonna talk about it. We're gonna talk about its chances, its rate of sales, and what's going down. But before we get into everything here, guys, please make sure you hit that like button if you do enjoy the daily content on the channel. Subscribe if you're someone new as well. And of course, comment on what you think about this when you're done watching the video. Also, make sure you check out our community polls page. We are starting to draw some inspiration from the polls there and making content based off of that. Some of you guys' answers might also be featured in my videos. In addition to that, we are going to start having some prizes and giveaways for people who do go to there and vote. So I do appreciate all the support that we've been getting, guys. You guys are voting, and I've been reading through the comments and everything. You guys are awesome. So thank you guys so much for that. But let's go in and get right into business here, guys. Let's talk about the Nintendo Switch. So the official sales as of December 30th, 2020, the Nintendo Switch is at 79.87 million. I'm counting right here, guys. There is only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 systems. Okay, so it's within the top 11. There's only 10 systems that are above it. We can pretty much go ahead and knock out the PlayStation Portable. That sold around 80 to 82 million, I think, on that. Don't quote me 100%, but I'm pretty sure it's right around that. I have a list here, but I'm not sure exactly how accurate that is, just because it's an estimate. And I don't know if Sony ever gave an official estimate on that afterwards. But anyway, it's in the 80 millions range. The Nintendo Switch is probably going to pass that up this year at some point. Obviously, it's going to pass it up. Then after that, you have the Game Boy Advance, which is at 81.5. 1 million systems sold. The Nintendo Switch is definitely gonna pass up the Game Boy Advance. That already puts it right there, like at number 8 or so. Then you have the Xbox 360 at 84 million. Okay, the Nintendo Switch is definitely gonna pass up that system. Then you have the PlayStation 3 at 87 million. And I think these numbers might be a little bit lower. I think the PlayStation 3 might be like at 90 million. And I think the Xbox 360 is a little bit higher than that. But this is the basic gist of what's going on here with the sales numbers. So if you look at all of that, the Nintendo Switch, by, I would probably say by mid-time this year or so, it's gonna pass up the PSP, the Game Boy Advance, the Xbox 360, and the PlayStation 3. That only puts the Nintendo Wii at 101 million plus, PlayStation 1 at 102 million plus, the PlayStation 4 at 115 million, and then you have the Game Boy and Game Boy Color at 118 million, and then the Nintendo DS family of systems at 154 million, and then you have the almighty PS2 at 155 million. So 100 million, in my opinion, is definitely going to happen. And let me tell you guys the reason why. Nintendo, for the past fiscal year, from March of last year to March of this year, they estimated, I think originally around like 20 something million systems sold, like 20 or maybe even lower than that, but they sold 24 million systems from March of last year to December of last year. 24 million systems. Now they revised their forecast to be right around 26 to 27 million, but they're probably gonna sell more than that because they have a killer February lineup with Persona 5 Strikers, Bravely Default 2, and also Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury. And you also have stuff like the Ghosts and Goblins game. So there's quite a number of titles coming out. So the Switch is going to continue selling. It's on a blistering pace in Japan, selling six figures pretty much every single week. So I think it's a sure bet, just based off of just the projection of what we've been seeing with the Switch, that it's going to pass up 101 million maybe by the end of the year. If they do what they did last year, it's definitely going to pass it up. Let's just say from March. So we can just say 9 months, including the holiday, they're going to sell 24 million systems. That puts it right there. You know, that puts it right there at 104 million. So that means it would pass up the Wii. That means it would pass up the PlayStation 1. And it'd be right underneath the PlayStation 4. So this is where, okay, we're in the top 4 systems here. That puts Nintendo Switch in the top 5. So if you look at it, the PlayStation 4, it's just at around 115 million. Sony put out their numbers recently. The sales have been slowing down quite a bit. The last quarter, they sold around 1.4 million systems. So if you just average that out, obviously that was the holiday season for more people buying. It's probably going to be less than that as people migrate from the PlayStation 4 to the PlayStation 5. So I wouldn't really put anything more than, like, let's say 10 to 15 million units left for the PlayStation 4, unless you see some type of crazy fire sale and there's a bunch of PS4s out there, which I'm not sure if there is, but it seems pretty likely that it's going to end right around 115 million to about maybe 120 to 25 million, somewhere in that range, unless sales just slow down completely off the face of the map. It does seem like it's going to hit maybe 120 to 125 million. So that's not bad. That's not bad. But the Nintendo Switch, if you look at it, if you count the 3 months that I'm saying right here, if you count the rest of the year as well, and the pace that they're going at with the software that they have, it's very feasible, especially if they have something new like a Nintendo Switch Pro or Revision or something to extend the life even more than what it was going, because it's already going really strong. It's very feasible that Nintendo sells another 25 to 30 million consoles again after they've hit the 104 million mark. So that would put them around 125 million or so, 125 to 130 million, just rough estimates here at the end of next year. So Nintendo, in order to pass up these last systems, right? Because with that 120 million or so, if they hit their targets, which they are, we've got big software coming out. There's a lot of big games, Monster Hunter Rise and The Legend of Zelda. If there's another Mario Kart or something like that, that already puts them past the PlayStation 4. That puts them past the Game Boy Color and the Game Boy. And that would put them right underneath the Nintendo DS family of systems. Now, they would need another 30 million units, okay, another 30 million to even be in the range, because they're at about 120 something million. So you need another 30 million to tie the Nintendo DS family of systems. So that would mean probably 2023 or right around that area, they maybe get to that point. So 2023, they get to that point. Maybe the next system is coming out or not. Maybe they've extended it with what they're doing. But either way, it's right around there. And then once you hit 150 million, you're right there in striking distance with the PS2, because that's 155 million plus. So could they reach it? Yes. And the year would probably be 2023. That would be the year. If they finish out this year with 100 plus million systems, which they're going to finish out this year with 100 plus million of systems, they hit another 25 to 30 the following year. Then in 2023, they hit another 25 or so in that year as well. And then even if you trail it off, let's say they do 15 million in the following year, then another 10 million the following year, that would get them right at where they need to be to pass up the PlayStation 2. So is it going to happen 100%? No, I'm not going to say that it's going to happen 100%. Is it very likely, or is it possible for the Nintendo Switch to pass up the PlayStation 2 and become the best-selling gaming device of all time? It absolutely is. But there's a couple things that Nintendo needs to do in order for that to happen. They need to continue the software, like The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild 2, stuff like that. Having sequels to the huge-selling games is going to be very vital and very key. If Nintendo migrates over to the next generation Switch too quickly, it can tank sales of the current Switch that we do have. That's why I do feel that they're going to release some type of enhanced system to where you can get better resolutions and stuff in order to extend the life in a bit and say, hey, we can have some nice resolutions, we can have some nice stuff on our system as well, but you can still play your games across all the different systems, having a nice family of devices. And I think that with that, they can extend it out to 2023 or so, and they can sell the needed systems they need to sell. Plus, you still have the Nintendo Switch Lite, which is essentially the successor to the Nintendo 3DS, right? It's a dedicated only portable. You got weaker graphics on there. You don't have the resolution that's as high. You can access certain frame rates that are better or whatever when it's docked. So you have that, and if they come up with a revision, it's even gonna put a bigger gap between that, and then the price could drop, because you have to remember, we still have no real price drop on this system. If you look at it with all of these other systems, every single one of them, all of these systems got real price drops within, you know, their third or fourth year, whatever the case is, in order to help them sell more. The Nintendo Switch still doesn't have a real price drop. All they really had was a lower end model, which got a cheaper price, but you get less functionality. So we haven't even seen a real price drop yet. And that could be a big boon as well if they knock off $50 from the top level Switch and then also the Switch Lite. So to me, with the price drops, with sequels to big games, like obviously Mario Kart 9, that would be a game that would help move a ton of systems. As long as Nintendo can produce them, they'd still keep moving them with it. So stuff like Mario Kart, stuff like The Legend of Zelda, I think even a game like Metroid Prime could help out quite a bit. The next Pokemon games, we're looking at potentially maybe Pokemon Diamond and Pearl being remade. I think that's gonna be good too. If they get another Pokemon game out in the next few years as well, I think another Let's Go game could help. I mean, there's a ton of different things that they can do here. Obviously, Super Smash Brothers is continuing to help. Maybe if there's another Mario game as well. Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury is looking pretty good. And I think even legacy games like The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD and also The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker HD, those can help move things as well. Nintendo has a lot of big guns in their arsenal, and I don't think they're going to be too afraid to use them. I mean, we've already seen a lot of cool stuff already on the Nintendo Switch. Many people actually really love the system. If you go and look at the polls that I'm having here, people think it's like their favorite one of all time. It's actually winning pretty good, but we're going to talk about my rankings and where I put everything in a future video. But overall, Switch is absolutely killing it at this point. And I think that logically, if you look at the numbers and you look at the pace that they're selling, they're obviously gonna pass everything up, because they're selling 25 million plus systems a year. They're gonna sell 25 million plus systems this year, and nothing's slowing down. The sales are still there. They're still winning NPDs. Everything's still going. And this year's lineup is absolutely big. Like, this year's lineup is really good. We're eating good already in February with Bravely Default, and also with Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury. With all the updates that game has, there's going to be a lot more for this year. I still think Bayonetta 3 is going to come out this year. Maybe not the biggest system mover out there, but still a game that's going to help people say, okay, maybe I might check out a Switch or a Switch Lite to play the game. So I feel that Nintendo has so much software and so many different things going for them right now when it comes to third party as well. Shin Megami Tensei, Monster Hunter Rise. I mean, there's some big games that are there that can move systems as well. Plus you start seeing some of the third party games coming in too, like Ys 9, for example, and the Trails of Cold Steel series coming over. All that stuff is really gonna help get some of the fringe people who haven't really bought in yet. And then also now with the popularity, you start seeing a lot of children wanting to get into the action and play what their friends are playing and everything. So I feel that it's a pretty good spot to be in. If you're looking at it here, Nintendo's going to pass up just this year in 2021, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 systems. I don't think it's going to catch the PlayStation 4 this year. That's going to be next year to where it passes up. But it passes up a number of big systems. I mean, the Wii is the big one here for everybody, you know, when it comes to Nintendo's best-selling home console of all time. That's the Wii. The Switch is definitely going to replace that. But it's an interesting thing to kind of go over and look at. And as I was researching and looking through all these different systems here, it's crazy just to see how much Sony, Nintendo. I mean, if you look at like the top 10, you know, it's Sony, Nintendo, Nintendo, Sony, Sony, Nintendo, Sony. You got Microsoft in there, but then back to Nintendo, Sony, Nintendo, Nintendo, Nintendo. Nintendo, you know, when it comes to things. So it's pretty crazy to see that there. And both systems are doing really good. The PlayStation 5 is doing phenomenal. The Nintendo Switch is doing phenomenal. Heck, in a few years, we might be talking about, okay, where's the PlayStation 5 gonna be at when it comes to best-selling all-time systems, you know, and everything? Because I think it's gonna be up there as well. I definitely think it's gonna at least match the PlayStation 4 with the minimum when it comes down to things. So we're gonna have to talk about that in a bit too, but they just got started, so we'll have to wait on that. But what are you guys' thoughts on this, man? I thought this was a fascinating discussion. It's a fascinating thing to look at. I think it's pretty cool to talk about this type of stuff. So what are you guys' thoughts? What do you guys think about where the Switch is going to end up? I'd love to hear what you guys have to say in the comment section below. All right, guys, that wraps it up for this video here. Check out the links in the description. We've got Twitter. Go ahead and give us a follow on there. Stay up to date on all latest gaming news and information. Also, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video if you can. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll catch you guys for the next one. Peace.